My respected brothers, sisters, honorable elders, noble blessed people. All of us, we know about the glory and about the height and excellence and honor of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned them in the Quran. All those ayat, they mention about the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about Sahaba. Even about specifically, إِذْهُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا إِذْهُمَا and they, both of them, two of them, in the cave. Abu Bakr Siddiq إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talking to his friend, his companion, who is that companion at that time? Abu Bakr Siddiq there are other آيات محمد رسول الله محمد الرسول of Allah والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يرجعون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود all about Sahaba فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا all about Sahaba رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه all about Sahaba وكل وعد الله الحسنى أبو صحابة أولئك هم المتقون إن طحن الله قلوبهم بالتقوى صحابة أولئك هم المتقون صحابة أولئك هم المفلحون صحابة أولئك الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned about their qualities, about their sacrifice, about their love, about their belief and faith and iman in the Quran. Well, respected brothers and sisters, why and how the Sahaba they achieved this level? To look deeper and to ponder into their qualities, the scholars they have abstracted and they have taken some of the very important and specific special qualities that every single Sahabi had that quality, that characteristic in his life that made him the companion of Rasulullah all the quality was acquired after the companionship of Rasulullah but these are those specific qualities it's that all these qualities surround the entire teachings of Islam. And first of all, number one is Iman, Al-Imam Billah. Believe in Allah, the strength, the height, the depth, the excellence, the passion, the determination, conviction, sacrifice for the sake of Allah as been shown and as been displayed and as been practiced by the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no one on the face of earth and there will be no one on the face of earth that can display or that can practice or that can show that much stronger and that much connected and that much constant iman with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Allah praised them, and because of their iman, Allah made them a role model for the mankind, for the humanity entirely. That Allah says their iman has been accepted. Their iman was on the level that Allah wanted, on the demanding level. And Allah said, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ The people, they're coming after you, the people, they will be following and they will be claiming to Muslim, to be Muslims and believers. The people, they will be following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this ummah later on, in the later part of this ummah, if they believe as you have believed, فَقَدْ اِتَّدُوا And then they will be on the righteous path and they will be guided. The iman was made an aim at the qiyam, a model for us. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them, praised them. Number one, iman. They never in any way of their life, they sacrificed even their life. Once, just once, say that Muhammad is not the Prophet of Allah. Muhammad, whatever he is saying, is false, incorrect. They sacrificed their life. They preferred to be killed. They preferred to be slaughtered. They preferred to be displaced. They preferred to migrate. They preferred to leave all of their lodge and their houses and whatever they possessed and contained in Mecca. They preferred to migrate and leave everything behind just for the sake of Allah, just to save their iman. Just to show and display that they can do anything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there were the people that when they used to face the death, subhanAllah, we say that someone faced the death, but we read in Qasas al-Arab and in Usat al-Ghaba and in Siyar al-Sahaba, the biography of their Lord, that they faced the death. And they used to say to the people who is coming as a death, bil mawti tukhawwifuni, that you are scaring us. You try to scare us from the death. We are not scared from the death. Even one of the Sahabi dying, the last moment, bleeding excessively and dying, and they know that we're gonna die. Fustu wa rabbil Ka'ba. I succeeded, swear by the Lord of Kaaba, swear by Allah, I swear by Allah, that I have succeeded. Khadar nalka al-ahibba, Muhammadan wa hizba. Are they going saying that? Then I'm going, I'm not losing. I am succeeded. Why? Khadar nalka al-ahibba. Tomorrow we are going to see and meet and visit, and we are going to join with our beloved ones, with our friends, with our companions, and they went and they've been departed and they've been called by Allah before us. Qadar nalqa al-ahibba, Muhammadan wa hizba. Tomorrow we will be joining again, we will be together again with all our companions, with all our brothers, and even with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the excellence and height of the iman. Number one quality of iman. La ilaha illallah. And Allah has examined their hearts, and Allah examined and tested them on the level of iman. And all the Sahaba, Allah certified them. Allah certified and sealed the Quran with the seal and with a stamp. كُلَّنْ وَعْدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah has promised with every single Sahabi Jannah. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُمْ. Allah says they are the only people after Anbiya, after the Prophets, that they got certified by Allah with His pleasure. No one else. No one else on the face of earth. And this certification will not be granted to anyone till the day of judgment and after the day of judgment, because Allah will grant this certificate those people after the questioning, after the reckoning. But Sahaba, subhanAllah, look at the speciality of the iman, look at the excellence, and look at the depth, and look at that connection and that passion of iman, that they are alive in this world, and Allah sent the certification, radiyallahu anhum, Allah been pleased with them, waradoo anhum, and they are also pleased with Allah. So this is quality number one. Quality number two is the second part of Kalima, Muhammadur Rasulullah. They were the real and true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, true students of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to do what they have seen or they have learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They used to ask every bit, even everything. Allahu Akbar. Allah mentioned their interest for knowledge and asking Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يسألونك عن المحيط, يسألونك عن الأهلة, يسألونك ماذا ينفقون, يسألونك عن الأنفاق. They're asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're learning from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're imitating. They're copying Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in everything. They are not deciding on their intellect. They are not taking any decisions, any step on what they think that I think
this might be my understanding. No. Even they were Arabs, even they knew the meanings of Quran, even they knew every single letter of Arabic. But they always asked Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And they copied Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every step of his life. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَصْحَابِي كَالْنُجُومِ فَبِأَيْهِمْ يُقْتَدَيْتُمْ اِهْتَدَيْتُمْ Allah, Allah, be أَصْحَابِي لَا تَتَّخِذُوهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَرَضًا فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّي أَحَبَّهُمْ وَمَنْ أَبْغَضَهُمْ فَبِبُغْضِي أَبْغَضَهُمْ
In the first hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, My companions, they all are like stars, كَالْنُجُومِ
They brought in stars. فَبِأَيِّهِ مُقْتَدَيْتُمْ If you follow any one of them, any one of my companions, اِهْتَدَيْتُمْ You will be guided, you will be on the right path. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned every Muslim, Allah, Allah, fi ashabi, fi Allah. Be conscious of Allah about my companions.
فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ Whoever loves them, فَبِحُبِّ أَحَبَّهُمْ It is as he loved me, or he loved me. Oh, their love is because of my love, and my love guides to their love.
You can translate it, you can explain it by every side. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّي أَحَبَّهُمْ Whoever is loving me, it is because of my love. If you love me, it means that you have to love them. And if you love them, it is out of my love.
فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّي أَحَبَّهُمْ And whoever hates my companion, he is hating me.
If someone hates Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he stands in Islam. If someone hates the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he stands in Islam. Because the love of Sahaba is the love of Muhammad, and the hate of Sahaba is the hate of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
So think about you before you hear someone, or before you watch someone, or before you see someone, that someone is talking about any of the Sahaba. Any of the Sahaba.
Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, not just these four, all the Sahaba,
even the last Sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, any single letter or word uttered against them or above them or doubtful about them, that is the hating towards them, and it leads towards the hate of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Criticism. No. Why? They've been disqualified already. Your criticism is going to go back to you.
Judgment. No. Why?
They've been certified already. They've been given the pleasure of Allah. They've been granted Jannah already. Your words, whoever is saying that in your word, whoever wants to examine them, whoever wants to judge them, whoever wants to criticize them, whoever wants to talk about what happened between the Sahaba. There is one topic. Some of the Muslims, they do and go deeper in those topics. That is Mushadaratu Sahaba. What happened between Ali radiallahu anhu and
Amir Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, what happened between Uthman radiallahu anhu and other Sahaba? What happened between Fatima radiallahu anha and other Sahaba after the death of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What happened between Aisha radiallahu anha, Ummuna wa Umm al-Mu'mineen jami'a, and Ali radiallahu anhu, or Amir Muawiyah radiallahu anhu? What was the background and what was the story? It is not completely not allowed to go, discuss, read, think, ponder, or to try to figure it out what was the story and what was the background and what was the history. Why the scholars they say that? Because we do not see and look into the life of Sahaba through the history. Through the books, we look towards the life of Sahaba and their honor and their respect and their excellence and their height and their glory in Islam through Quran, and Quran has already certified them with the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever happened in the past, it has gone in the past. Allah certified them. So the following of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was the second quality that they had. Iman billah. Ittiba' al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number three. Connection with Allah through prayer, through salah. Inna salata kanat 'ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. Qum fasalli. فَإِنَّ فِي الصَّلَاةِ شِفَاءً. صلاة الصلاة بين المؤمن وبين الكافر، بين المسلم بين الإسلام وبين الكفر. الصلاة إني افترضت على أمتك خمس صلوات وعهدت عندي عهدا من حافظ عليهن لوقتهن أدخلته الجنة ومن لم يحافظ عليهن فلا عهد له عندي. As-salah. They used to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they used to cure, and they used to fulfill their necessities, their needs, and they used to solve and resolve their problems through salah. Sajda, the strongest and the heaviest and the fortunate and the luckiest person in this world is the one who knows to put his forehead on the ground every time, any time, not just the knee, no. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised their ibadah, their dhikr, for salah is a form of dhikr. رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. They are the men. رجال, as we say in Arabic, رجل. You are رجال. They were رجال. They were the real men. And what is the quality of being real man? لا تلهيهم. Does not their tijara, their business, their selling, or their all their activities do not deviate them, and do not stray them, and do not make them busy away from the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their hearts are filled with iman, even they are in tijara, even they are in their business. Salah, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. Sick, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ask him, what happened? He put out to ya Rasulullah, I'm feeling pain in my tummy, my stomach, in my intestines. Here, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh, pray. Allah has put cure in prayer. Idha hadabahu amrun بادر إلى الصلاة. وفي رواية إذا حذبه أمر صلى. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. What is that? Lunar eclipse, solar eclipse, Salatul Kusuf. Why? Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, anything happening in your life, Allahu Akbar. That is the way. That is the light. Connection with Allah. Ali رضي الله عنه used to say, when I want that Allah talk to me, I read Quran and I feel Allah is talking to me. And when I want to talk to Allah, I start crying. So my brothers, if we make an effort to acquire and get these qualities and follow the footsteps of Sahaba, inshallah we will be guided. And this is not it. About the ilm, about the dhikr, about the akhlaq, about the ikhlas, about the da'wah. Inshallah, I'm going to mention those qualities inshallah in the next Friday. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to live our lives according to the Prophet and follow the footsteps of Sahaba and to live our lives according to the Sunnah of the beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the brother in Indonesia being hospitalized, his name is Joko Arianto Putu. The brother is in hospital sick. May Allah grant him shifa. May Allah grant him good health, grant him sabr, patience. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. My brother Al-Falib, he is sick as well. May Allah grant him shifa. May Allah grant him and stay in touch him, inshallah. And all those brothers and sisters that have departed from this world and pulled back by Allah. May Allah grant him jannah and firdaus. May Allah grant sabr to their families. A very special and humble request of dua for the brothers and sisters in Palestine. May Allah grant them ease, inshallah. And may Allah remove their burdens and their tests and their all the hardships they have gone through. And may Allah grant them to those they have departed. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen.